Assalamualaikum and salam sejahtera. Hi everyone. Hope that all of you in a good health. Today we continue our lecture on metal. I will not go in detail as you have learned its properties in previous lectures. In chemistry, a metal is an element that readily forms positive ions or cations and has metallic bonds. Remember that it is a lattice of positive ions surrounded by a club of delocalized electrons. A combination of a metal with at least one other metal or non-metal is called an alloy. Remember that an alloy can be formed from a solid solution or compound or a mixture. Metals and alloys can be divided into ferrous or non-ferrous material. The ferrous metals or alloys contain large percent of iron. These are the examples of ferrous and non-ferrous metals. The ferrous metals exhibit magnetic properties and poor resistance to corrosion and rust. Vice versa, the non-ferrous metal is a non-magnetic material and more resistant to corrosion. The advantages of ferrous metals are the iron ores exist in abundance. Economical extraction, refining and fabrication techniques are readily available. It can be tailored to exhibit wide range of properties. It exhibits high strength. Its magnetic properties make it useful for large electric equipment and motors. And the most important thing is that it can be recycled. On the other hand, the non-ferrous metal exhibit high corrosion resistance, ease of fabrication, good thermal and electrical conductivity, and presence in an attractive color with low density. The disadvantages of the ferrous metal is that it is susceptible to corrosion and relatively high density and low electrical conductivities. On the other hand, the non-ferrous metal exhibit low strength at high temperature. Carbon is usually added in steel to increase its hardness, its strength, or its corrosion resistance. However, it reduces its ductility and weldability. There are two types of carbon steels, i.e. the cast iron and the wrought iron. The cast iron contains 2-4% carbon and the wrought iron contains less than 0.08% of carbon. The cast iron is a bit strong in compression but weak in tension and bending. Since its structure is crystalline, therefore, it is relatively brittle and it also exhibits poor weldability and ductility. On the other hand, the wrought iron is more tough, malleable, ductile and easily welded. However, the cast iron can be recycled and does not rust. The wrought iron can be heated and reheated and worked into various shapes. Since cast iron is a melted iron that is poured into a mold, therefore it is used in wide application such as in a construction, in automotive parts, kitchenware, and pipes. Note that in cast iron may also contain other elements such as silicon. The hard properties of the wrought iron makes it widely used in making bars, garden furniture, and also in the building of the Eiffel Tower. wrought iron is no longer produced on a commercial scale. It is now replaced by mild steel that contains 0.05 to 0.30% of carbon. Thermal processing of metal is to control the microstructure and the mechanical properties of metal alloys. When a material is heated above its upper critical temperature and immediately cooled to room temperature, the process is called as quenching. There will be no changes in the microstructure of the material. However, if the material is put on hold at constant temperature before it is cooled to the room temperature, then the process is called as annealing. This is when we expect changes in its microstructure. Thank you, everyone.